Another key to a strong nuclear security system is to have a threat-informed approach to creating these physical protection systems. In order to have a threat-informed approach, nuclear security planners must understand all potential threats and create their physical protection systems accordingly. First, they should analyze the likelihood of each threat, and next, they should analyze the forms in which this threat might appear. One way to do this is with a threat matrix. A threat matrix basically analyzes the intent of an adversary times their capabilities. The intent would be how determined an adversary is to access protected material. The capability would mean the material means by which they would access the nuclear material. These terms are then placed on a matrix like the one that you see here. The top right box is the box with the highest threat. The bottom left will contain the least threatening adversaries. So we can go over an example. We're looking at a hypothetical terrorist organization. It's a large, organized terrorist organization. It's concentrated in country A, and it has little opposition from the domestic government. There are several targets. Your country is one target, country B, country D, and personnel and businesses from targets located in country A. There's an affiliate organization, or there are many affiliate organizations, located in country C, which borders country D. Lone wolf actors are known to operate in your country, but so far, you've experienced few attacks. Lone wolf actors also operate in country B. Country B has experienced more attacks than your country. And they're also experiencing an upsurge in radicalized pockets of their population. This terrorist organization is known to have connections to heavy arms dealers in country E. It's shown willingness to use tactics on large areas of the public and does not target specific populations. It's also acquiring funds through front companies and charities located worldwide. Large amounts of funds are coming through, used to buy arms from country E and provide salaries and benefits for those operating within its network. Now, we will place this hypothetical terrorist organization on the threat matrix according to the threat to each state. So first, we'll analyze its capabilities. Its capabilities are high, so we see it's very well funded, it's a large terrorist organization, it has advanced arms capabilities, so we'll have it pretty far to the right of the spectrum. We will place it here. Now let's analyze its intent. Its intent might be different in regards to each country. So for country D, they have the highest intent towards country D. It's a bordering country, there are cells located in country D, and it's easy to access to attack country D. So country D will have this adversary highest on the spectrum. Country B might be next. So there are lone wolf actors active in country B, and it has a recently radicalized public. However, country B might feel comfortable that it's less likely to suffer a large-scale attack because of distance. This could be true, could be not. But it might affect their analysis of the group. Your country would be next. There are lone wolf actors, however, there have been few attacks, and there is distance between. Country E would be low, they're not a target country. Country C, fairly low, not a target country. Country A, probably medium, because although they're not a direct target, they could experience side effects of the group targeting other targets within their borders. So, as you see here, each country might view this terrorist organization to have a different level of intent and capabilities relative to that country. So after determining the threat of this hypothetical terrorist organization, a state national security regime can then allocate resources accordingly. Country D will want to allocate a high amount of resources to securing its radiological facilities, especially since it is the most high intent for an attack. This is called a design-based threat approach, or a threat-informed security design. The state outlines the adversarial characteristics and then designs their facilities to protect against each adversary, which a state might encounter.